Hello, I'd like to share some information with you today in regards to some tips to being happier and making 2021 the best year you can possibly make it. This information today is coming from Forbes, from contributor Brian Robinson. So if you're like most people, you may not want to revisit the painful events of 2020 as we close the year out, and that's understandable. The pandemic has left a mark on every aspect of our lives. We have lost loved ones, friends, colleagues to coronavirus, and it has altered the way that we live, the way we entertain ourselves, the way that we shop, work, and engage with our loved ones. We've been faced with the worst economic crisis in history, from food banks, self-quarantines, face coverings, threats to the frontline workers have become a part of the new normal. So, as we leave 2020 behind and we look at the positives on the horizons for 2021, of course, there are going to be hardships and heartaches, and those won't automatically disappear at the stroke of midnight on New Year's Eve. The fact is, the pandemic will still be here, and it can feel like an uphill battle, but with support, that uphill battle may feel a little less bumpy. So, obstacles are going to be thrown our way. There's good news. Grass grows through concrete. So, we have more power than we realize. If we are faced with the pandemic opposition in 2021 with positive attitudes, emotional stamina, and stability, we can get through this no matter the obstacles. So here are some tips to take into 2021. When negativity like the pandemic strikes, our power comes in the way that we respond to it at times. And it is not easy. It's hard. And these 10 tips for 2020 in your favor can help you with supporting you through going into the pandemic in the new year. These are including and not limited to, though. Okay? So, focusing on the upside of a downside situation. When there are so many incidences of devastation, fear, and heartbreak, it's natural to focus on the downside of the pandemic. But we can balance that out with what it's brought us as far as people together, volunteering, helping one another, and strengthening the idea of collective selflessness. What's an upside that you can name? Give that some thought. Two, pinpointing the opportunity in the difficulty. Ask, how can I make this situation work to my advantage? Can I find something positive in it? What can I manage or overcome in this instance? During the pandemic, we can use time for self-reflection and to think about what direction we want to take the new year. What opportunities do you see? Three, frame 2020 as a lesson learned, not misery to endure. Ask what you can learn from the difficulties of 2020 and use them as stepping stones instead of roadblocks. Think of adversities of 2020 as happening for you instead of to you. If you consider this perspective less taken, what has 2020 taught you that you can take into 2021? Four, practicing gratitude. Look beyond the fear, the loss, the disappointment, and at the big picture. Take an inventory of your life and include all the things that the pandemic prevented you from doing once you took it for granted. And consider all people and things in your life that you're grateful for, letting gratitude steer you beyond gloom and doom. So the question is, what are you grateful for? Be chancy, number five. Take small risks in new situations instead of predicting negative outcomes before giving them a try. How can you stick your neck out for the new year in a safe, healthy way? Six, avoid blowing a situation out of proportion. Do not let one negative experience rule your whole outlook. What is limiting situations that you can minimize or overcome in 2021? Seven, focus on solution, not the problem. You'll find more empowerment to cope with the pandemic curves when you step back from a problem and brainstorm a wider range of possibilities. The negative bias can direct you to zoom in and focus on the problem. And though, when you broaden your perspective, wide angle range, sorry, you will help see the potential in the bigger picture. The question for you is, what possibilities do you see for 2021? Eight, practice positive self-talk. I think this is really important. During rough times, be kind to yourself as you would be to your best friend. Underscore your triumphs. So replace begrudgingly or begrudging, excuse me, self-thought, put down criticisms, and practice self-compassion. Affirmations and affirmation feedbacks are pretty beneficial and helpful. Give yourself a, okay, you did good. Throw modesty out the window and remind yourself of all of your personal resources. The question is, what are some of your strengths? Nine, practice solitude. So solitude, it can be good for you. It takes you out of the rat race for a while, gives you a bird's eye view of your daily life, and replaces chaos with serenity. Possibly spend 5 to 10 minutes of the day alone if you are able to meditate, practice yoga, contemplate nature, connect with the larger self. The question is, what brings you inspiration, peace of mind, and solitude? How can you practice solitude? And 10, see a fresh start contained in loss. Every loss contains a gain, and you do have to look for it at times. Every time you get one more time that you kind of fall or stumble, you can increase the likelihood of scaling hard times. The question is, what endings in 2020 contain new meanings or beginnings for you in 2021? Every loss is not a loss. Sometimes they are a gain, and we have to find gratitude in the silver lining at times with that. I hope this information was informative. Please, 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 please gain further support with a mental health provider to help you through not only the pandemic, but 2021 and all of the opportunities and possibilities that can be out there. Have a good New Year's and enjoy your time. Bye-bye.